where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the way. At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the way. Then, of course, we have the Jonquil. The Jonquil is a masquerade dance of the British. It's a dance that would dress up in the costume. There will be a belly woman, which is a pregnant lady, a goat-headed creature. They will bring the knife and the fork and the Dutch pot to create music. They would have the grater and they beat the foot back, cover them together, bing, 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 and the knife and the fork, and they would chant and gyrate down the street. We still have Jonquil festivals and Jonquil parties even today before COVID. Every summer and every winter in the Bahamas, especially in Nassau at Cable Beach, they have the big Jonquil festival. Now, doing this dance, you have to lose your mind once, and you have to lose it so hard that it scares you. But we're going to give you a little bit of the Jonquil festival, or we party. Here we go. Beyonce sing and dance at the same time. It ain't easy. But yes, now the British gave us until 1840 to see if we'd survive on our own. I mean, we didn't know how to live, how to go out there and survive. The apprenticeship started in 1834. Thanks to six national heroes and one heroine who assisted in the abolishment of slavery,
We just had our Heroes Day, a national holiday in Jamaica. That was on October 18. Six national heroes. Sir Alexander Bustamante, and he became the first Prime Minister of Jamaica. We have Paul Bogle, who's a Baptist. Samuel Sharp, we have his own teacher's college, and the Samuel Sharp Square, with his monument located in the St. James Montego Bay area, the square. We have George William Gordon. We have Norman Manley, which is an airport in Kingston called the Norman Manley Airport. And on the 7 miles beach stretch is the Norman Manley Boulevard. We have Marcus Osiah Garvey. Now, Marcus Osiah Garvey was the first national hero, and he was the president and the founder of the UNIA. He led people from all race, color, ethnicities come together and live under one umbrella. There's a Marcus Garvey School in the United States and one in Jamaica. And he used to do barter exchange, where he used to carry papayas and other fruits and vegetables to like Fort Lauderdale, some part in New York, in Miami. And of course, the tourists would come down on top of the boat or the ship. And then you have Nanny of the Maroons. If you notice, the song says Maroons. Nanny is from West Africa, the Akan region, along with Captain Kodjo. Nanny took 5 gunshots in her asset and still survived today. Well, still survived at the time. Nanny is a fierce, phenomenal black woman. And the Maroons were defiant slaves who helped slaves to escape while they go back and damage the land and properties to the plantation owners. That's why the song says, Maroon gone, Maroon gone, Maroon left the pot on fire, Maroon gone, because they'll be cooking their food, but when something's going on, they'll defend each other. Even today, we have Maroons still living in Jamaica. They have their own town, their own government, their own rules. There's a place in Saint Elizabeth called Akompong Town. That's a Maroon town right there, and there's a place in St. James which have a big Maroon town, their own town. Maroon town, it's called, actually called Maroon Town. Now, slavery was abolished August 1, 1838. Remember, so then it was still 1840, and the apprenticeship started in 1834. But slavery was abolished 2 years successfully earlier than the allotted time given. August 1, 1838, and that is known as the Day of Freedom. Bob Marley says, emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free your mind. Have no fear for atomic energy, and none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we...
Old pirates, yes, they rabbi, sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the end of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the...
Now, Jamaica became independent August 6, 1962.
Enough music, enough.
Enough music. Jamaica became independent August 6, 1962. And from there on, with our innovative spirits, we proudly acknowledge our national symbols. The national tree of Jamaica is called the Blue Mahou also known as the Hibiscus elatus, and that tree is very good for making furniture. The national flower is called the Lignum Vitae. Pretty little flower, have the lavender-ish color, and it's good for medicinal purposes. The national dish of Jamaica is called the Aki and the saltfish. Now, the Aki is a fruit which we got from West Africa by Captain Bligh, and the saltfish is known as the codfish, to which we received from Newfoundland, Canada. And our national bird is called the doctor bird or the swallowtail hummingbird. It is a hummingbird with a very long tail, which is said to be indigenous. Has the colors of the Jamaican flag, and why they call it the doctor bird is because the back of the bird is shaped like a doctor's coat. The national dish, the Aki and the saltfish. Now, on our coat of arms or motto states, out of many, one people. I believe in America you have it in Latin, e pluribus uno, out of many, one. Now, because we are proud Jamaicans, and we represent the colors of the Jamaican flag, which are black is for the hardship and the creativity of the Jamaican people, green is for the lush vegetation, and gold is for the sun which shineth forevermore. We aim to promote our lifestyle of living, enhances our roots and culture, and captivate that colorful image of Jamaica. Now, ladies and gentlemen, with due respect, we're going to kindly ask for you to stand at attention for just 2 minutes of your time out of your busy holiday or vacation, and listen to the words of the Jamaica's national anthem.
Eternal Father, bless our land, guard us with thy mighty hand, keep us free from evil powers, be our light through countless hours. To our leaders, great defender, grant true wisdom from above. Justice to be ours forever. Jamaica, 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 land we love.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Now, to wrap things up, Jamaica is the first largest English-speaking island in the Caribbean. It is estimated 4,414 square miles, which is about 239 miles in length, 90 miles width, and 90 miles south of Cuba. Jamaica's highest mountain peak is the Blue Mountain, which produces coffee, and 90% of the coffee is exported to Japan. Jamaica is around 2.8 million people and still growing. Our island is consisted of 14 parishes, which are like your provinces or states from the United States. And they're divided into three counties that are of British names. We're talking about Cornwall, Middlesex, and Surrey. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you really and truly enjoyed our history of Jamaica, let me say amazing.
Amazing.
Thank you very much. And just to let you know, I'm playing a character, okay? So, like Aunt Bam or like Madea. So nobody should get too judgmental about, yes, thank you about that. Now, ladies and gentlemen, of course, we have the man Christoph, my grandson. He'll be walking around with a basket for a little token of appreciation. We empower the youths. They say ignorance enslaves, but knowledge liberates. So come and support the Spotlight Foundation, and we have our projects working on, but we can speak after the show. $1, $2, or $5, or $20. It's okay. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We have aerobics going on now with the man Happy Feet. That's our aqua.